So in this lecture, we will discuss problems on binomial distribution, Poisson distribution and geometric distribution, continuous random variable, x, expectation and variance of x, exponential and gamma distribution. With the user notation, find p for binomial, variate x even is 6 and this equation, 9 into probability when x is 4 equal to probability when x is equal to 2. So for the binomial random variable x with parameter n is equal to 6 and p, the probability function is defined as probability when x is r is 6 cr p raised to r q raised to n minus r, where r runs from 0, 1, 2 up to 6. We are given this equation, so put in this form. So put here x is equal to 4 in this equation. So this is 6 c4 p4 q square is equal to, put x is equal to 2 in this equation, this is 6 c2 p square and q4. So if you solve this equation, now by the property we know that ncr is equal to ncn minus r, that is you can write 6 c4 is equal to 6 c2. So finally this 6 c4 and 6 c2 are cancelled out, and finally we get 9 p square is equal to q square. This implies you can write as q is equal to plus minus 3 p. Now case first, taking positive sign, we get q is equal to 3 p. Now q is the probability of failure, which is equal to 1 minus p. This is 1 minus p is equal to 3 p, and hence we get 4 p is equal to 1 and p equal to 1 upon 4. So this is the required answer, and if you take the negative sign, say case second, if we take negative sign, then q is equal to minus 3p. Therefore, we can write this equation 1 minus p is equal to minus 3p, and this is equal to 1 is equal to minus 2p, and means this is equal to p equal to minus half. But the probability is not negative, so the only possible value is equal to probability is equal to 1 upon 4. Next one, Poisson distribution. A random variable x is said to follow a Poisson distribution if it assumes only non-negative values, and the probability mass function is given by this equation, exponential minus lambda raised to x upon factorial x, where x runs from 0, 1, 2, 3, and the parameter lambda is greater than 0, that is positive real number. We use the notation for Poisson distribution as follows. And Poisson distribution is a limiting case of the binomial distribution under the following conditions. So there are two conditions. The number of trial is large, that is n tends to infinity. Second is the probability of success of each trial is very small, that is probability tends to 0. So using these two conditions, we get finally np equal to some value lambda, which is finite. So from this equation, we can write as p is equal to lambda upon n, and we know that q is equal to 1 minus p. So substitute the value of p in this. So q is equal to 1 minus lambda upon n. For Poisson distribution, mean is equal to lambda as well as variance is equal to lambda. Now some examples of the Poisson variables are as follows. We use the Poisson distribution in the following cases. Number of deaths from a disease such as heart attack or cancer or due to snake bite. Second, the number of suicides reported in the particular city. Third, the number of defective material in a packing manufactured by a good concern. Fourth, the number of air accident in some unit of time. Fifth, the number of printing mistakes at each page of the book. Sixth, the number of cars passing a crossing per unit during the busy hours of a day. And last one, the emission of the radioactive particles. So these are the following cases where we use the Poisson distribution. If x is Poisson variate such that this equation holds, then find the mean of the x. So we already discussed the probability mass function of the Poisson digit is given by this equation. So clearly, first of all, put x is equal to 2 in this equation. So we get exponential minus lambda into lambda square upon factorial 2 is equal to, now put here right hand side 9 into x is equal to 4. So you can write as exponential minus lambda is a common. So this is 9 lambda raised to 4 upon 4 factorial plus 90 lambda raised to 6 upon 6 factorial. So solving this, finally if you solve this equation, this term are cancelled out. Finally we get lambda 4 plus 3 lambda square minus 4 is equal to 0. So this can be reduced in quadratic in lambda. We take as lambda square is equal to t. So this reduces to t square plus 3t minus 4 is equal to 0. So finally we can write t is equal to minus 3 plus minus, this is 3 squared, that is 9 minus 4 into minus 4 upon 2. So this is t is equal to minus 3 plus minus root 25 upon 2, and hence t is equal to minus 3 plus minus 5 upon 2. So first we take a positive sign, that is minus 3 plus 5 upon 2, then we get t equal to 1. So for positive sign, t is equal to minus 3 plus 5 is equal to 2. This is equal to 2 upon 2 is equal to 1. And what is now t? T is equal to, put the value of t, which is lambda square is equal to 1. This implies lambda is equal to plus minus 1. But we know that the lambda is greater than 0. So only admissible value of lambda is equal to 1. So we can neglect this value lambda is equal to minus 1 since lambda is greater than 0. Similarly, if you take negative sign, this is not possible. If you take negative sign, then this is t equal to minus 4, implies lambda square is equal to minus 4. So in the real system, this is not possible. The square of any number is not negative in the real system. So we ignore this sign. Next one, so therefore finally we get lambda square is equal to 1, and hence lambda is equal to plus minus 1. Now since lambda is greater than 0, this implies we take only the value lambda equal to 1. And we know that the mean of the Poisson distribution or a Poisson variant is equal to lambda, and in our case lambda is equal to 1. So therefore mean of x Poisson variant is equal to 1. Next one, geometric distribution. A random variable x is said to have a geometric distribution if it assumes only a non-negative values and its probability mass function is given by this equation q raised to x into p, where x runs from 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. And otherwise this value is equal to 0. In this case the mean is equal to q by p and variance is q by p square. We write here as mean is, we know that mean of this x is equal to summation x into px, probability mass function. So this is x, and what is the px? Px is equal to q raised to x into p, where x runs from 0 to infinity. Now put one by one the value of x. So when x is 0, first term is 0, then put x is 1, we get qp. Then put x is 2, 2q square p plus 3q p and etc. Finally we take as a qp as a common, we get 1 plus 2q plus 3q square and so on. And this is the arithmetic geometric progression. So the final value is written as qp 1 minus a raised to minus 2. This is the standard result, where is the common ratio of the geometric series. The common ratio of the geometric series is obviously q. So put a is equal to, where a is equal to q. So therefore this is equal to qp 1 minus q raised to minus p. So you can write this equation as q qp upon 1 minus q dash square, you can write now qp upon, now we know that the 1 minus q is equal to p, so this is p square and p and p square cancel out, we get q upon p. So similarly we can find the value of variance q upon p square. Now to find variance we compute first expected value of x square. This is equal to summation x square px, and this is where x runs from 0 to again infinity. X square, what is px? Qxp. Now put the value x is 0, it is first term is 0, then x is 1, qp, then x is 2, then 4, q square p, then 3 it is 9, qqp and etc. So finally we can write now qp again as a common. This term reduces 1 plus 4q plus 9q square and so on. This again the standard, we use the standard result, and this can be written as qp 1 plus a multiplied by 1 minus a raised to minus 3, where a is equal to the again the common ratio of geometric series. So geometric series you see this is 1, q, q square and so on. So again a is equal to q. So put the value of a is equal to q in this. So this is qp 1 plus q, 1 minus q minus 3, and hence it is qp 1 plus q upon 1 minus q cube. And finally you can write qp into 1 plus q and this is pq. This is cancel out, we get q upon p square into 1 plus q. So this is the expected of x square. And finally we can find the value of the variance of x in the case of geometric distribution by using this result, expected of x square minus expected of x whole square. Put the value of expected of x square, which is q upon p square into 1 plus q minus expected of x is, we already proved, q upon p. So this is q upon p whole square. And finally if you solve, first term q upon p square, second q square p square, and third one is minus q square p square. This is cancelled out and finally we get the required value of variance of x is q upon p square. So hence proved. So the mean of geometric distribution is equal to q upon p and variance is equal to q upon p square. Next one, continuous random variable. So this is the definition of continuous random variable. If x is a random variable which can take all values in an interval, then x is called a continuous random variable. Example, person's height. So for a given interval it takes any value, and distribution function fx of may be represented as fx is equal to probability when x is less than equal to x, and integral representation lower limit minus infinity to upper limit x fx dx. Now where the function fx has the following properties. First one, fx is greater and equal to 0, and second one, the integration of fx with respect to x between the limit x is minus infinity to infinity is equal to 1, because the total area is equal to 1 since it is the probability density function. The function fx that satisfied first and second condition is called probability function or probability density function. Now consider the small interval x and x plus dx of the length dx round the point of x. Let fx be any continuous function, probability that x falls in the given interval is given by this. So probability when x falls between these two values, x and x plus dx, is equal to fx dx. So if x is continuous random variable, then the probability that x takes on any one particular value is 0. And for interval, probability that x lies between two different values a and b is given by this. So clearly, probability when x lies between these two values is equal to integration a to b fx df, where fx is probability density function. So this is the remark the probability when x is greater than equal to a, less than and equal to b is equal to probability when x is greater than equal to a but less than b, equal to probability when x is greater than a but less than and equal to b, equal to probability when x is greater than a and less than b. So in this case of continuous random variable, it does not matter whether we include the endpoints of the interval from a to b. So in all cases, probability is same. Now, expectation and variance of continuous random variable x. So in previous lecture, we already discussed the expectation and variance of discrete random variable in some property. Exactly in similar way, we can define here. Expectation of x is given by this result. Expected of x is the integration, the length minus infinity to infinity x fx dx, provided right hand side integral is absolutely convergent. That is, this value, absolute value of fx is equal to mod of fx into fx is less than infinity, then we can say that the integral is absolutely convergent. Also, we define expected of x square by this equation, and hence variance of x is given by this equation. Now, some problems. Probability density function of continuous random variable x is given by this. So, find k, mean and variance of x, and cumulative distribution function of x. So, we can calculate one by one. Since we know that this integration, the range is here x is 0 to 2. So if you break the entire range minus infinity to infinity, then the only non-zero values where the function lies is in this interval 0 to 2. So finally, when x is lying between this 0 to 2, this value is equal to 1. Now put the value of fx, fx is given. So put the value 0 to 2, fx is kx 2 minus x. Now integrate with respect to x, taking k as a common. Now this is x into 2, 2x minus x square. This is k. Now integration of this first term, integrate x, we get x square upon 2, and the limit is 0 to 2 minus the integration of x square is x cube upon 3, and limit is 0 to 2 is equal to 1. So this is cancelled out, we get k, put the upper limit 2, that is 2 square 4, lower limit is 0, so minus 0. And this is minus 4 to x is 2, so this is 8 upon 3, and lower limit is 0. So this is equal to 1. So this is k, taking as a LCM 3, we get 12 minus 8 is equal to 1. And finally, we can write as k into 4 upon 3 equal to 1, and hence we get the value of k as 3 upon 4. For this value, finally the integration is equal to 1. Next, we find the mean of x. So, mean of x is the expectation of x. In the case of continuous random variable, we already discussed how to find the expectation of x, which is equal to the integration range is 0 to 2 x fx dx. This is 0 to 2 x. Now put fx, so fx is here kx into 2 minus x. Now we already compute the value of k, which is 3 by 4. So you can write now, put here 3 by 4. So 3 by 4, 0 to 2. This is x into x, x square, 2 minus x. this can be written as 3/4. First term 2x square minus second term x cube. Now integrate with respect to x, we get this implies expected of x is equal to 3/4. Now integrate first term 2x square, we get 2x cube upon 3 and limit is 0 to 2 minus x cube, this is x 4 upon 4 and limit is 0 to 2. Now this is 3/4 and this is 2/3. Put the value of upper limit x, that is x is 2 cube. Lower limit is obviously 0. Minus 1 upon 4, put the upper limit 2 raised to here 4. And hence we can find the value as expected of x is equal to this one, 3 and 3 cancel out. And this is 2 raised to 4 upon 4 minus. This is 3/4 into 1/4, 2 raised to 4. So, this is 16 upon 4, 4 minus 3 upon 16 into 16. So, this is cancel out and finally we get 4 minus 3 is equal to 1. So, mean value of x is equal to 1. Now, we find expected of x square to compute the variance of x. So first we find the value of expected of x square. Now expected of x square is again we use this 0 to 2 x square fx dx. Put the value of fx. Fx is kx into 2 minus x. And k is obviously we already calculated 3/4, so this is 0 to 2 and this is x cube 2 minus x dx. So expected of x square is 3/4 and the integration 0 to 2, first term is now 2x cube minus this is x raised to 4. So first of all we integrate with respect to x and then the taking the limit. So we can write now 3/4. So integrate first here 2x raised to 4 upon 4 and limit is 0 to 2 and this is x raised to 5 upon 5 and limit is 0 to 5. So we solve for this. This is equal to 3 upon 4, this one is cancelled out, 1 upon 2, taking limit upper 2 raised to 4 and lower is 0 obviously. When put x is 2, upper limit 2 raised to 5 upon 5. So after solving we get as this is 3/4 and this is cancelled out, then 2 cube this is 8 minus 32 upon 5. 3/4 taking as a HM 5, so write down as a 40 minus 32 which is 3/5 and this is 8 upon 4. So this is 6 upon 5. So therefore expected of x square is equal to 6 upon 5. So we compute first mean expected of x is 1 and then expected of x square which is equal to 6 upon 5. So we use the standard result how to find the variance of x in case of continuous random variable. So next one is variance of x. So variance of x is expected of x square minus expected of x whole square. Put the value. This is 6/5 minus 1 square is 1. And hence we take 6 minus 5 upon 5. This is equal to 1 upon 5. So required variance is equal to 1 upon 5. Finally, we find the commutative distribution function or a simple distribution function of x for this probability density function for x. So CDF is required. CDF is now we know that when x is less than 0, obviously there is no value of non-zero value of fx. So this is equal to 0. Now we compute this interval only when x lying between these two. Also when x is greater than or equal to 2, finally we get to 0 value as a 1. So this is equal to 1. So we find the commutative distribution function for this range 0 to 2. So the definition of the CDF, we can write fx as probability when x is less than x, which is minus infinity to x. So in our case, this is 0 to x only. So this is 0 to x, fx. Upper limit is fixed here, x. Lower limit, we take as the from this interval, 0. So this is 0 to x, and fx is kx multiplied by 2 minus. Now put the value of k in this. K is already solved, 3 by 4. This implies fx is for this range 3 by 4. Put the value of k, and this is multiplied by 2 minus x by x. So this is 2x minus x square. This is 3 by 4, integrate, we get 2x square upon 2, and this is minus x cube upon 3, and range is 0 to x. So 2 and 2 cancel out, 3 by 4, put x is x, so x square minus x cube upon 3. And finally, we can write as 3 upon 4, 3x square minus x cube upon 3. This one is cancelled out. The required CDF is 1 upon 4 multiplied by 3x square minus x cube. Next one is exponential distribution. A random variable x is said to have an exponential distribution with parameter theta, which is greater than 0, if its probability distribution function, probability density function, is given by this. Fx theta is theta exponential minus theta x, for x is greater than or equal to 0, otherwise this is equal to 0. So mean of x is equal to 1 upon theta, and variance of x is 1 upon theta square. So this is very easy to prove. Again, mean of x means expected of x. So expected of x is the integration, the limit 0 to infinity, and x fx dx. So put the value of fx and hence find the value. Similarly, we can use the standard result, variance of x is expected of x square minus expected of x all square. So finally we get variance of x is 1 upon theta square. Next is the lack of memory property. If x has an exponential distribution, then for every constant a greater than or equal to 0, the probability when this is a conditional probability when x less than or equal to a, and here y is less than or equal to x, is equal to probability when x is less than or equal to x for all x, where we define y as x minus a. This is the lack of memory property. Next one is the gamma distribution. A random variable x is said to have a gamma distribution with parameter lambda is less greater than 0 if its PDF is given by this exponential minus x, x less to lambda minus 1 upon gamma lambda, where lambda is greater than 0, and x lying between this x is greater than 0 but less than infinity, otherwise it is equal to 0. So, in case of gamma distribution, mean of x is equal to lambda and variance of x is equal to lambda. So, in the discrete distribution, where the Poisson distribution, where mean and variance are equal, similarly, in the continuous distribution, like a gamma distribution, where the mean and variance are also equal, so we can compute the mean of x for this. So mean of x means expected of x. So expected of x is the integration x fx dx. And range is 0 to infinity. This is 0 to put fx exponential minus x, x raised to lambda minus 1 upon gamma lambda. This is finally we get 0 to infinity e minus x, x raised to this is lambda dx upon. This you can written as gamma of this lambda is 0 to infinity. This x you can write exponential minus x, x raised to, you can write as a lambda plus 1 minus 1. By using the standard result, we know that the gamma function is gamma n is equal to 0 to infinity exponential minus x, x raised to n minus 1. So using this fact, we can write here, this is 1 upon gamma of lambda. So if you compare with this, so in our case here, n is equal to lambda plus 1. So put here as of the gamma of n, that is n is this. And we use the recurrence relation, gamma n plus 1 is equal to n into gamma n. So this can be written as lambda into gamma n upon gamma of this lambda. This one is cancelled out, we get. So we also compute the value of expected of x square. Expected of x square is 0 to infinity x square fx dx. And what is fx? Exponential minus x, x raised to lambda minus 1 upon this gamma lambda dx. Finally, we can write as t minus x, x raised to here lambda plus 1 dx is equal to gamma of lambda. Finally, you can write as this can be written by some adjustment, adding plus 1 and minus 1, you can write lambda plus 2 minus 1 to convert in standard form. Now if you see this integration, if you compare this integration with this, obviously the n is lambda plus 2. If you compare both the integral, so we see that n, in our case n is equal to lambda plus 2. And finally, this is improper integral, the first, any one of the range of integration is infinite, so this is gamma function, gamma of n. So finally, we can write here as, in term of the, by definition of gamma function, this is 1 upon gamma of lambda, this can be written as gamma of lambda plus 2. Using the recurrence property, you can write here, lambda plus 1 into gamma of lambda plus 1, gamma. Again using lambda plus 1 into, you can write lambda into gamma lambda upon, this one is cancelled out. So finally we can write as lambda square plus lambda. So expected of x square is equal to lambda square plus lambda for this gamma distribution. So hence we can write as variance of x as expected of x square minus expected of x whole square. Expected of x square, put the value of expected of x square, which is lambda square plus lambda. Minus put expected of x, which is lambda. So therefore, lambda square plus lambda minus lambda square. This one is cancelled out, we get this value is equal to lambda. So this is the exponential distribution. Now the one of the problem of Poisson distribution, we check here. If x and y are independent Poisson variable, such such that probability when x is equal to 1 is probability when x is equal to 2, and probability when y is equal to 2 is equal to probability when y is equal to 3. Find variance of x minus 2 pi. So now we get to here as, since x follow Poisson distribution with parameter lambda and y follow again the Poisson distribution with the parameter mu. First of all, we write down the PMF of this. So this is PMF is for first case, and for this second case we use the another parameter mu, exponential minus mu, mu raised to y upon factorial y, where y is again 0, 1, 2 and x. Now put the value in this Poisson distribution. X is Poisson variate and again y is also Poisson variate, both are independent. So we can write the value, so is x is 1 and y is 2 now. So x is 1 and y is 2. Since we have given probability when x is 1 equal to probability when x is equal to 2. Put here x is equal to 1, so exponential minus lambda, lambda upon 1 factorial. This is exponential minus lambda, lambda square upon 2 factorial. Solving this we get exponential minus lambda, lambda we get 1 minus lambda upon 2 is equal to 0. Now since for any finite value e minus lambda is not equal to 0, and also lambda is greater than 0, so only possible value is 1 minus lambda by 2 is equal to 0, that is lambda is equal to 2. In similar way we can find the parameter y. The another condition is probability when y is 2 is equal to y is 3. So we use this again, probability when y is 2 is equal to probability when y is 3. We use this probability mass function. So put y is 2 in here. So exponential minus mu, mu square upon 2 factorial, exponential minus mu, mu cube upon 3 factorial. This implies exponential minus mu, mu square upon 2. And this is exponential minus mu, mu cube upon 6. This one is cancelled out, and finally we get, again you can cancel these terms, so you can write now mu is equal to 3. So x follow Poisson distribution with parameter lambda equal to 2, and y follow again Poisson distribution with parameter mu equal to 3. Now since x follow Poisson distribution with parameter lambda, this implies variance of x is equal to lambda and lambda is equal to 2. And also y follow again Poisson distribution with parameter mu, we can write the variance of y is now equal to mu, and mu is equal to 3 now. And hence we can find the variance of x minus 2y using the property we already discussed in the property of the variance and expectation. Variance of x minus 2y is equal to variance of x plus minus 2 whole square, that is 4, into variance of y. So this is equal to variance of x is equal to 2 plus 4 multiplied by variance of y, which is equal to 3. This is 2 plus 12 is equal to 4. Hence we have the variance of x minus 2y is equal to 14, where the x and y are the independent Poisson.